Beloved in the Lord, we want to bless the name of the Lord for the beauty of His holiness. We had a beautiful Palm Sunday celebration yesterday, and I want to thank all of you for your prayers, for your messages, and for the encouragement, and for all of it, for the gifts. I need to thank all of you. But please continue to pray for me even as you pray for yourself. This week begins the journey to the cross, and it's the last week of our season of Lent. As we continue in prayer and fight and fasting, even in the midst of all the distress around this COVID, we believe God is making a way. Today, Monday, to bring us the first word for the week is the Reverend Dzidor Atsakpo, who is the presiding elder of Tema District and the pastor of Metropolitan AME Zion Church. As we begin this worship, in the name of God, who alone is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, please bow with me in prayer. Father, in the name of Jesus, we glorify you. We are nothing without you. We acknowledge our frailty and we submit unto you that, Lord, you have mercy upon us. Cleanse us and put a right spirit within us, that even as we continue to wait upon you, remembering how much you suffered and died for us, Lord Jesus, let your spirit pour afresh upon us. Let your anointing pour afresh upon us. Let your enabling presence be our portion. The Lord Jesus, even as we journey with you to the cross, we'll always be mindful that you are God. And you only deserve all the praise, honor, and adoration. And you only can make all things good and beautiful. So Lord, have your way with us. And speak to us, even in our hearts, even through these meditations, that we shall be restored. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Enjoy the worship, enjoy the service, and I believe God will speak unto our hearts again. Thank you very much.
Just fine. This morning's reflection is titled, God Speaks Into Every Situation. And the scripture text is from Isaiah 42, from verse 1 to 9. The passage shows God speaking into the painful exile to send a servant who will bring justice not only to Israel, but to all nations all over the world. A little background of this scripture talks about how God delivered Israel from bondage in Egypt, how he made a covenant with them, how he brought them through wilderness into the promised land of Canaan, how they became a nation and built a temple for themselves. And for many years, they experienced military victories. They had defeat over their enemies through the hands of their kings and their generals. But however, the Israelites strayed from God's covenant. But then they were called back by prophets. The question might be, what happened then? One, Israel was defeated by Babylon. They were destroying their temple, took their treasures away from them. They brought them back to the gate of Babylon in chains. That was when they sang this song in Psalm 137. By the rivers of Babylon, there we sat down and wept and remembered Zion. They remembered the joy that they encountered when they were on that land. They enjoyed the sweetness of their relationship, which were taken away from them. Israel was defeated by Babylon. This was a complete devastation of political, social, economic, and religious life Israel had known many, many years. It's just like seeing what we are seeing in Ghana and all over the world, the COVID-19. The experience that is going all around. We have had a lot of enjoyment. We have a lot of good fellowship in our churches. And now we've been asked to stay home without going to associate, without going to sing praises and to meet one another. It is just the same thing. We are all feeling loneliness. Israel experienced the same thing. Beloved, it is difficult for anyone to understand what Israel went through if you are deprived of what belongs to you as a child of God. If you were once a servant, if you were in prison, humiliated by your own enemy, you know what Israel went through. The question is Israel abandoned to an enemy? How could God allow this to happen? Were they still God's people? Was Israel still a nation of God? Was God still their God? And so that comes this song, where is our God? When we go through frustrations in life, when things are not going the way we want it, we begin to sing songs. Where is my God? Is God hearing me? Is my God around me? Why am I not married? Why am I going through this frustration? Why all this happening to me? Beloved, all this comes on us for us to learn a lesson and for God to prepare us for the victory ahead. Hallelujah. It could be concluded that grace has run out from them, and Babylon to punish them for their sins and disobedience. When we are going through trials and temptation, frustration, when times are hard for us, it looks as if the grace of God is no more around us. It seems as if we are not closer to God. It seems as if there is something wrong in our life, and our God has closed his ears to us. But I want to assure all of us that God is closer than us before. Whatever we go through in life, it is known to God. And he will make a way where there seems to be no way. Hallelujah. Within this identity crisis, the prophet Isaiah speaks and reminds Israel of who God is, how God works, what God is doing by sending a servant. A God not of Israel only or Babylon, but one created heavens and stretched out the earth. A God who called Israel to righteousness and to keep them. This servant is spirit-filled, not a tyrant. Not a bruised reed he cannot break, but a liberator who will bring justice, not domination. That is the God we have. Our God is a God of freedom and of liberation. And so whatever you are going through, there is time for everything. You will not be a slave forever. You will go through and you will come out of it. And I believe that what Ghana is going through, what the world is going through, one day we shall overcome. We shall come out of it, even in the name of Jesus Christ. Secondly, God works to bring justice on earth everywhere. The servant will persevere until justice is done to the coastal land. God is still working. He's still working. A victory shall be assured one day. Thirdly, God purposes his people to be a light to the nation, to open the eyes that are blind, to bring out the prisoners from the dungeon, from the prisons, those who sit in darkness. Isaiah reminds his exiled people that God has not abandoned them, but is hard at work with them and in their midst with sole purpose of restoration. God is still working. Hallelujah. God is still at work, and he will restore the thing that the devil has taken away from you. He will bring back your joy, and all your unfertile lines will be made fertile in due course. When God's time comes for you, you shall smile and you shall laugh. God is still God. God's people are still his people in their separate situations. In your separate situation, God is still working. God's attention is not therefore on Israel alone, but on his purpose and plan to declare new things that spring forth. A futuristic vision. God has a plan for your life. Through Jesus Christ, that plan will materialize. Through Jesus Christ, you become victorious and a winner, because God has a purpose for you. Verse 9 says, behold, the former things are come to pass, and new things do I declare before they spring forth. I tell you of them. Hallelujah. God has promised you that, behold, the former things, the old things are no more. They will come and pass. And God is going to declare new things in your life. Before they spring forth, you begin to know. Whatever is happening to the world today in Ghana that we are confused and frustrated is a thing that will come to pass. We shall overcome one day as we join our forces in prayer, as we begin to call upon the name of the Lord. As we cry unto him, he will hear us and he will answer us. May the Lord bless you and keep you, that these words will enter into your heart. Believe with faith and walk by it. Thank you for your attention, even in Jesus' name. Amen. Let us pray. We bless you, God, for you have sent forth your word. Your word cometh forth to accomplish the purpose for which it has been sent. I pray in the name of Jesus Christ that those who heard your word, Lord, who have the benefit of it. Bless them. Bless them. In Jesus' name. Amen. Beloved, you have heard my voice. You have heard the word of God. It is your time to give your life fully to the Lord Jesus Christ. This is a Passion Week. And as you accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior, Jesus, he will come into your life and be the Lord of your life. If you have not accepted him, you are walking your own way, this is the time for you. He knocks at your door. If you open your heart, he comes in and dine with you and be with you for the rest of your life. If God comes into your situation, all your problem, all your sickness, and everything that you are praying about, everything that you are seeking for, every plan of your life shall come true. I pray with you that God will answer you. Amen. And now may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, guard your heart and mind through the knowledge and love of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Go and enjoy the peace of our Lord Jesus, who has died for you. Amen.